in control, getting rid of Listen, because from the get-go, I have found that really self-confident horses mm-hmm. like she is, and intelligent on top of it, are much more interested in their surroundings than they are in
But they think they already know what we're doing.
Yes. Yeah. Uh-huh. And so she tunes out a lot, which is, of course, the very reason why we do halfpots. Because it brings her back into consciousness of what the rider is doing.
You hear that?
And she's not, she's absolutely not dependent on a rider. She just, you know, goes her own way and does her own thing, and if you're up there, that's fine, and if you're not, that's fine too.
Oh, come on, Temple, you think you can go in there and do a test without anyone on you?
Poop. Absolutely. And probably enjoy it. Back, back, where are you going? Hey, hey.
You wouldn't know which test to choose.
And then, bless her heart, there are horses like Thissy who can't do anything without me. And I mean anything, bless her heart. She doesn't have an ounce of confidence.
How can that be when you trained her?
That's the reason she's so dependent on me. I mean, she's just, that's her, no, that's her nature, just as Temple's nature is confident and independent. It's like people, you know, some people have a natural self-confidence and some people don't.
Well, yeah, but.
And sometimes you can gain self-confidence and sometimes you can't. But Temple was born like this and Thissy was born like that.
Yeah.
She's scared of her own shadow and
yeah.
takes cues from other horses. It's curious to me because this is very aggressive with other horses.
Yeah.
But again, if you, and but she depends on them. She's not a leader. She's not an alpha mare. She's uh-huh. just aggressive, especially at feeding time.
Yeah.
Get out of my way. Come here, let me look at your nose. Hey, you're okay.
She was a bit stressed there for a bit. In the
oh,
recovery.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
She got over it.
She starts to working on her lips.
Yeah, that's a pretty funny sign.
But that's the reason I didn't write my test, because she's got it memorized.
Oh. Maybe you should do your test backwards, too.
Yes, I do it.
You could do it backwards, not just.
No, thank you. I'm a genius, but it doesn't stretch that far. Oh, goodness.
I guess it's hard to canter backwards, except I can make
you know,
canter backwards.
Jesus, Rebecca's husband that died of cancer, could.
Really?
Yeah. He was really a genius with
wow.
training horses. Very poor instructor, and part of it was due to a language barrier.
Mm-hmm.
And there were a lot of funny things that happened between the two of us, even though I speak Spanish very, very well. I speak Mexican Spanish,
mm-hmm.
and he speaks
Spanish, or
Spanish from Spain, which is a little different. It's like English from England and English
yeah.
from the States. There are certain expressions that are very, very different. And I don't know all of the expressions, the equestrian terms, I guess I should say, in Spanish. And the equestrian term for half pass is apoyo, which also means support. And I was in class with him and he was asking me to do an apoyo. And so I just got stronger and stronger and stronger with my legs and my hands because I was trying to support her. And he did not mean support, he meant half pass.
Oh.
And I was just getting, I was to the point where I could not physically do it anymore. And I finally stopped and I said, Jesus, you know, I'm squeezing and I'm using my legs and my hands and I'm using all the strength I can muster, and I cannot get any more of I can't support any more than what I'm doing. And he starts to laugh and he says, I'm not asking you to support, I'm asking you to do a half pass.
That's kind of funny.
And there were several things that he did in Spanish. Toes and fingers are the same word.
Oh.
Dedos, D-E-D-O-S. Dedos and dedos. And even before I met him, a friend of Rebecca's was, Jesus was based out of Norco at first. And Rebecca would take a group of friends up to Norco to have class with him. And one of his students, by the name of Dina, was, a very, very nervous person and lacked self-confidence. And when she got uptight, like Temple does with her lips, she would do that with her toes, with her toes. And Jesus kept yelling at her, relax your dedos. And so she finally just turned loose of the reins completely. She was, you know, her fingers were just as relaxed as they could get. And then he yells at her, no, the fingers on your feet. So there were a lot of little things.
So he could see her toes and her shoes?
Well, you can see.
Yeah.
Look at my foot. See? You can see it. Yeah. And he was very observant and very aware. He trained horses for he started out at the Spanish riding school.
Is that how you met Rebecca?
Yeah.
What did he die of?
I'm sorry?
What did he die of?
Cancer. Pancreatic cancer.
Well, I think it took long, then.
Took 6 months from the time he was diagnosed to the time he actually died.
That's horrible.
It was. Poor Rebecca, I feel so sorry for her. This is her third husband, and both the first two died.
That's scary for the third
hold
one.
Hold on.
The first one?
From a guy's point of view, I'd be checking on that girl.
I'd be worried too.
Her first husband committed suicide.
Oh, that's really mean.
That's what
in
they all say.
In their car, in their garage,
that's
where
what
she
they,
lives currently.
That's what they all say.
No, well, that's, yeah, she got home from work and found it. Can't you just imagine?
That's so mean.
I can't even fathom that.
I can't even.
What did he do? He started the car and just sat in the garage?
Yeah. And he was very, very organized, and he left detailed instructions for her about the mortgage, about all of the money, about just about everything, about the house. And it took her completely by surprise. She had been married about 4 or 5 years. He was a nurse.
Mm-hmm.
You know those green scrubs that I wear when we show those belong to him.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah. I never met him. He was long gone before I met Rebecca, and I didn't find out for a long time that her husband had actually committed suicide, and she was.
Yeah, that would.
Before she got involved with Jesus, she was taking class with me. And as a matter of fact, she took the circuit championship, I think I told you that, at training level on her stallion. She was in the arena once with me, and we got to talking about that, and she told me that he had committed suicide, and I nearly fell off of the horse. I've never known anybody, you know, that happened to. And then she meets Jesus, and I think Jesus has really been the absolute love of her life.
Mm-hmm.
And they were married exactly a year when he was dead, Mr. Kessler.
Oh, they didn't have much time to get around. What does she do for a living?
She works for the city of San Diego, and she is some kind of a personnel supervisor. I don't know exactly what her title is, but she has climbed up to the highest rung on her particular ladder. And she's been there for like 25 years. She's just about ready to retire. She's
probably ready to get her off payroll.
Yeah, she's, I want to say 53.
Uh-huh.
She's the same age as Dale, exactly the same age as Dale. And Dale had a really bad crush on her, too.
Did he?
Yeah. And I kept learning she's a beautiful woman.
Yeah, she's striking.
She's striking. And she's classy, young. And she's got a very, very kind heart. You know, she had invited me to go with her and Sheila. Did you meet, you didn't meet Sheila.
Sheila, was that the lady that stayed at your house with her at dinner on Christmas or something?
No, I don't think you met Sheila. Sheila is an unusual person, too. Anyway, she was at the wedding, and she's a good, good friend of Rebecca's. And she was going to go with us today. Sheila is another one of those people that doesn't have any self-confidence with horses. Anyway, she's a funny lady. Now, why did I start to say to talk about Sheila?
We were talking about Rebecca.
Uh-huh.
I don't remember.
I don't either. Anyway.
And Rebecca still has a bunch of horses, or she has
Yes,
one?
She does. She has a mare that Jesus made her promise that she would keep forever because she was just, she has string halt. Do you know what that is?
That's something with her back leg that we gotta make.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
With one back leg, it jerks up. It's a neurological something, and nobody's ever been able to figure it out, but it happens. And she's a registered thoroughbred. And she has her stallion, and her stallion is now 24 or 25 years old. He's just retired, and he just stays with his mares. And she also has two Andalusians, one of which Jesus worked with to run pretty level. Beautiful gray. I want to say he's about 11 or 12.